This video is the first of a number of videos in which we show you how you can construct your own catapult. We provide you with constructions for both EV3 and NXT versions of the robot, and you can use these very funny constructions to fire different small LEGO parts to about meter and a half. It's completely automatic, you can load it and reload it completely automatically, and we'll be happy to get your feedback and for you to try to construct this robot in your home or in your classroom. First, I'll start with the base of our catapult. It's a very simple construction with just a frame and four beams attached to each other. The larger this base is, the more stable the catapult will be when it fires different small parts. Now, I won't be constructing the robot every step on the way, so I'll just show you how you can attach the basic modules and what's the idea behind them. With two of these modules, we built the vertical frame of our catapult, and it looks something like this. A problem with this frame is that it's not very stable. As you can see, it's kind of fragile. So we can solve this with adding two additional beams that will attach the frame to the base in a certain angle. Just a moment here. Here it is, and now it's much more stable than the other frame. And we do this on the other side also. The second step of building our catapult is to build a lever that will fire the small LEGO parts. We'll use something like this, and now we must find a way to fire them. And I've built a lever here. It works in the following way. We attach it to the frame like this. And now it moves freely up and down. If we find a way to add some parts at the end of this lever that will hold this small LEGO part, and we'll be able to fire it like this. And again, I've come up with a solution to this, and we use this red angle beams. It might not be red, of course, and we attach them to the end of the lever. And now we can actually fire our part. If I move the lever very fast, it will fire the part like this. The last step of building our catapult is to find something heavy that we can attach at this end of the lever. And when we press probably a button or something, it will lift the lever and fire the part. A simple solution is to use the brick in your sets, because the brick is probably the most heavier part. And here I'm showing the NXT brick, but you also have a constructions and instructions for building the robot using EV3 version of Mindstorms. And to actually hold the brick and use its weight at the one end of the lever, I've built this, let's call it a nest. And we could add the brick to the nest. It's mainly constructed from angle beams and a frame and some pins that attach all the parts together. And now we should find a way to attach the nest to the lever so that we use the gravity force. And when the bricks moves down, the lever moves up and we fire parts. For this, we could use the following mechanism. We could touch one beam freely here. and then attach the nest to the one side of the lever. Here it is. I'll make it more stable. We add a bush here and here. And it works in the following way. When you release the lever and the brick goes down, the lever goes up and we can fire apart. Here it is. Again, this is how the whole construction works. Because of the gravity force, when the brick goes down, the lever goes up. And if we have a part right here, we can fire this part. I'll just leave it more freely. What you can see is that the lever moves from one side of the robot to the other, and that's not how a catapult is supposed to work. So we should add some kind of a stopper right here at the upper side of the frame. And if we add this stopper, let me just attach it. We can see that we fire the parts, but the lever stops. We can experiment with different positions of the lever depending on the force that we would like to use for firing and when should the lever stop. For example, right here, it's on the second, and we add it like this, and we attach a bush on one side and bush on the other side. Now again, and one more improvement we should add is a small axle at the lower part of the catapult, right here. We'll need this axle in the next episode, and it also helps for the lever not to reach the ground. Then we have a working catapult. One more bush missing on this side. Here it is. Let us fire something. Okay, I'll be happy to get your comments, and in the next videos we will attach a motor and a sensor to the construction so that we could make it completely automatic.